Hey everyone, hope you guys are doing well. I'm Shubham and you're watching Let's Create an App. So in this video, we will see how we can create an application in which video is playing in the background of any screen, just like a login screen or a sign up screen. So this kind of functionality I've seen in the Uber application in which video is playing in the back of the login screen. So I'm just trying to create this kind of functionality. So let's look into the demo first and then we will see how we can create this kind of functionality. So as I click on this application icon, so there is a background is playing in the back and all the things are coming in the front with logo, label and buttons. So we are going to learn this thing and you can customize this thing according to your own need. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you are new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. So let's start the video. Let's create an app. So open an Xcode, click on single view application, click on next and give the whatever name you want to give. I'm just giving video play in background. You can give something else and just click on next and just create this project on desktop or somewhere else where you want. Now after creating this project, first we have to move on the storyboard so that we can design the thing which you have seen on the demo part. So now let's take one view first so that it is a kind of a player view on which video is playing. So simply type view, or you can use UI view, be specific. Now just drag and drop this UI view over here, and from all the four sides we should need to provide zero constraints and like this. And okay, fine, from all the four sides we have just provided a zero constraints. Now let's make the color of this view to black like this. And even you can also give the safe area, you can remove the safe area. So just from the top we need to put here this top one, and over here you have to make it to super view like this, and then make this constraint to zero, and same for bottom, this one, this one, and make this to super view and change this to zero like this. Now we have to take one image view as we have seen in the demo. So there is one image view, and we have to place the image in this image view, this circle image, and just drag and drop the circle image in the asset folder. Right now we can't able to drag and drop in asset. So first let's open the asset and drag and drop in asset. So after successfully dragging drop in the asset folder, we have to move on the again on the storyboard, and let's select this image, this one, and just give the constraints like from let's fix the height and width, and from the top it should be like 150 pixels or 140 pixels. It's totally up to you. And even you can give this thing in a multiplier, it's totally up to you. And a center horizontal. Now we have to provide two buttons. Even one, we can also take one label. So simply write UI label like this. Now we can give this label like LCAA, let create an app, and increase the size of this label something like this, and change the color to white. It's totally up to you which color you want. And give the constraints to this label something like this. Now we have to take two buttons so that whenever user click on any of the button, they can move on some other controllers like a login button and a sign up button. This should something like 26 pixels like this. Now we have to take two buttons, so simply write button. And let's first design this button. So the name of the button is like sign up, and the text color should be like white, and the background color of the button should be like take any color, it's totally up to you, yellow color. And we have to copy this button in two. So by pressing alt key we can copy this button with all the properties. Now take these two buttons in a stack simply like this. And now we have to fix the height of one button so that it will automatically maintain the size like this, and we have to change the property of this distribution property of this stack to fill equally, and we have to reduce the spacing between them to 10 like this. Now we have to just place this stack at the bottom of this view. So from the bottom it should be like 60 pixels, and from left and right it should be like 40 like this. So it's looks something like this, and it's not looking that much cool, but yeah, if we have some designer, then definitely this this thing will look very cool. Let's increase the space like 90 pixels like this. So maybe this looks something like this. Now we have to take the constraints of all these things. Even we can also provide text fields over here. So it's totally up to you what you want to draw. Now let's move on the view controller file class. Now let's take the outlet of all these things. So this is a preview layer. So simply write video layer like this, and these are the outlets. So we need the outlet of all these things because we need to put all these things in front of the layer, this video layer. So we need to use one method that is brings a view to front. So we need to take outlet of all these things. So image, label, sign up, and this is sign in. So we need to provide all these things. Now we can also increase the height of this button like 50 pixels. Okay, fine, like this. Now we have to create one method, and we also need to import the AV foundation. So import AV foundation like this, and now we can create functionality of playing video. So now we need to create one method which is responsible for playing the video and as well as putting all the views in front of that video layer. So we have to simply create one function, and the name is like play video like this. And in this, first we have to get one video which will play behind this view, and for that I've just already taken one video that is an intro video. You can get this video in the project file. The link is mentioned in the description. You get this video, and now we need to get this video first. So for that we need to use bundle. So get path equals to bundle dot main dot path, I guess path this one, and in this we need to pass the name of the file, so that is intro. And off type is .mp4, we can simply use mp4 like this. Else we need to return like this. Now we need to create one object of AV player layer and AV player. So first let player equals to AV player this one, and in this we need to use this URL, and in this URL we have to use this path method, and in this we need to pass the path like this. Now we also need to create the object of AV player layer. So let player layer equals to AV player layer this one, and in this we need to pass the layer. So simply get this AV player, and we have to pass the player over here like this. Now we need to set the frames of this player layer. So player layer dot frames is equals to self dot view dot frames dot bounds like this. Now we need to do one more thing. We need to provide a player layer gravity, and gravity is responsible for stretching the video or compressing the video if you want to fit that video in the screen, or it is okay if the video is move out from the screen. So this is what gravity do. So player layer dot gravity, video gravity is equals to dot resize aspect fill this one, and now we need to add this layer in the self.view, or we can say that that is video layer. So self.video layer dot layer, and this we need to add this sublayer, add sublayer this one, and in this we need to add a player layer this one, like this. So by doing this thing, we can simply add a layer in this video layer. Now we need to play the video, so for that we need to do player dot play. So let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. So just run this method from view did load like this, and just simply run this thing in iPhone 11 Pro Max. So let's switch on this thing like this. So let's wait till the iPhone simulator will run. And video is not playing, the simply screen is visible but video is not playing. The issue is like the target membership is not selected at that moment. So now I've just selected the target membership, and now it's able to run the video. So let's run this thing. I've just checked this thing that it is working fine or not, so that's why I put all these breakpoints. So the video is playing, but where are the views are moved? So they are in the background. So for that we have to simply put those views in front, or get those views in front of these views. So for that we have to simply create like video layer dot bring subview to front this one, and in this we need to get the image like this, and we have to copy this line and paste as many views as we have. You can also create function for this thing, like label this one like sign up button, sign up like this. So all these things will come in front of that view. So let's look how it's looking now. So these two things are working, those buttons are not visible. Probably the reason is that we have put all these two things in a stack, so we need to also create the outlet of this stack. So just go over here and click on this stack view and create the outlet of this stack view also. So simply like this. Like this, and we also need to get this stack view in front. So just paste one more time and just stack like this. And I think it's working fine now. Let's run this thing again and check that it is working fine or not. So by doing this thing, you can play any video in the background, and you can present your design in front of any video, and that look really very cool. Just like we are seeing that iPhone is coming, and you can design this video can also be customized up to you. So this is for today. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button, and if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. Meet you in the next video. Thank you.